What up? You know I gotta set it up first. You already know I gotta set it up first. So if you're tuning in, get yourself set up. Cause I got it pretty much set up. Uncle Pluto 2K, I like your name, bro. It's dope when you can get a dope name that everybody can kind of like remember. Like you can tell people your name, be like, yo, my name Uncle Pluto 2K. It sound cool coming out. Omega 2003, that sound cool. Profit Fitness, like look, y'all got some cool names already popping in. Oh, my name Uncle Pluto. What's up, y'all? We in here. I just wanted to see if y'all could hear me. Obviously, y'all can hear me. Oh. All right. So, my name is Bruce, and I am going to be guiding you through the session for today. If you got music, you can turn it on. I'm going to be turning on music today because I want to. Couple tips. Your mat should probably be straight forward like this, facing the screen. My mat is gonna be like at an angle here so that you can see me in a different anatomical position. But I'll also be popping up here to show you things that you need to see a little closer. Outside of that, meet me in a seated position, preferably a cross-legged seated position on your mat. And we will just stop the stop. So in this position, I want you to think about sitting up as tall as possible. When I say sitting up tall, it means having a long spine. The globe, the ball in the back of your head, that is up as high as possible, but still keeping your chin at a neutral position. So not reaching the top of my head up here and not tucking it too tight. Just keep it in neutral, if just maybe a little bit tough. Reaching my, sitting up as tall as possible, and then just breathing here. Taking a moment to just stop before we start. And in our breath, we want to bring a little bit more intention by expanding them, both the inhale and the exhale, and then making them the same length. So if your inhale is a 5 count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, your exhale is that same 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale. Feel free to close your eyes or keep them open. If you keep them open, maintain a soft gaze, meaning don't stare at anything, stare through it. Taking a moment to stop before we start separating this moment from any moment previous or the anticipation of any moment afterwards. Exhale, full expansive inhale, 3, 4, 5, hold it at the top, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hold it at the bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hold it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hold it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, inhale, 1, last one, 2, 3, 4, 5, hold it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hold it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, inhale, exhale, completely open mouth, one more time, inhale deep, expand your chest, expand your rib cage. Exhale, open mouth. For the remainder of the class, I want you to think about breathing through your nostrils, inhale and your exhale, so that we can start to build internal heat. When you need to cool down, if you need to cool down, breathe through your mouth, or exhale through your mouth at least. Inhale through your nose, exhale through your nose. Throughout the majority of the class, we're gonna meet in child's pose, so knees wide on your mat. Knees wide on your mat, toes to touch, sitting back on your heels, placing your torso in between your lap, walking your hands forward as far as your fingers can reach, and then placing your forehead down the center on the mat, your third eye hitting the mat, and just breathing here. This is a good time to tap into your Uddiyana Bandha, so pulling your core in and up. So the muscles in your core, pulling them, engaging them to pull in and up to help protect your lower back. Listen for an auditory sound of your breath. So your exhale should be loud, almost like you're constricting the back of your throat to create a hissing sound. This is a child's pose you can come back to at any point of the class. This is a very restorative pose, a very restful pose. So at any moment, feel free to come back here and just breathe. Walk your hands back to the sides of your chest. Press yourself up to a tabletop position. That is wrists, palms directly underneath your shoulders, knees directly underneath your hips, about hips distance width apart. We're gonna do a little cat-cow here. So associating your breath with your movement, just to jump it off, exhale. And on your inhale, lift your gaze. Rotate your hips so that your lower body goes, your lower back goes down, and your tailbone goes up. And then on your exhale, round your back, tuck your chin, pull your pelvis through towards your wrists. Inhale the opposite, lift your gaze, arch your back, exhale into cat. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. And feel free to add any organic movement, side to side movement that you would like to add. This is a great place to do that. Continuing in that same fluidity of breath as you move through your cat-cow, or even if you just move around here on your hands and knees. And when you're ready, press through your palms, all four corners of your palms. Lift your hips up and back for a downward dog here. So this is our first downward dog of the day, so feel free to pedal your feet out. Send your hips back and forth.
be long on one side, be long on the other, but I want you to think about making sure you're grounded through all four corners of your palm, okay? So the inner palm wants to raise up sometimes. Make sure you're grounded through all four corners of your palms. Lift your armpits up to the side, and then send your shoulders back down your back, okay? So it almost feels like you're dropping your head a little bit closer to the mat. And then just extend long through your upper body, press through your hands, make sure you're engaged all the way, keeping your biceps separated from your ears. This first hour, dog, is going to be a little bit longer one. Enjoy it. Again, feel free to move around. Remember to engage that Uddiyana Bandha, that pulling up and in of your core. On your next inhale, raise up on your toes. And on your tippy toes, slowly walk up to feet meeting your palms. Separate your feet about hips distance width apart. Bend your knees until your torso, your rib cage, hit your thighs, and grab opposite elbows. Let your head hang. Rock back and forth. Shake your head, yes. Turn your no. Just hang out here and let gravity take hold of your upper body. Release your neck. Relax your neck. Continuing to breathe deeply, expansively, fully exhaling. And keeping your head hanging down to the ground, drop your hands down to the ground. Head and hands are the last thing to come up. Heel toe your toes back to touch, or your feet back together. Slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time to standing. Head and shoulders should be the last thing to come up. At the very top, give yourself two shoulder rolls back while lifting your gaze, continuing to send your head backwards. And then two shoulder rolls forward to bring your head back to neutral. And then the Birdman hand rub of prosperity and abundance. Bring your hands to heart center. We're gonna go into some sun A's, sun B's. It may sound crazy, but we come go outside to some sun A's and sun B's. So when you're ready, come to the top of your mat. And at the top of the mat, make sure you're grounded through all four corners of your feet. So that might mean that you lift up your toes off the mat. So lift your toes off the mat and just make sure the inner knuckle underneath your big toe, underneath your pinky toe, and then both back sides of your heels are grounded to the ground, okay? From there, just make sure you're not leaning forward too much or too much backwards and you're standing up tall as possible. Again, starting your hands. And the Birdman hand rub of prosperity and abundance. And we're going to go with the music. So inhale, reach up high. Then exhale, forward fold. Bend at the hips, bend your knees if you need to. Touch the ground. Inhale, halfway lift. Place your palms on your shins or keep your hands on the ground. Extend your crown of your head towards the front of the room. And then exhale, place your hands down and meet me in a plank pose, plank position, okay? Plank position here. I want to make sure that my palms are directly below my shoulders. I'm not too high with my butt. I'm not sagged too low, okay? I'm in a strong, controlled plank. That might mean I rotate my hips forward a little bit. That might mean I need to drop myself down to the knees, but I'm going to hold this plank for as long as possible, okay? Now, while you hold this plank, make sure you look up at me so I can describe these chaturangas through vinyasas that we'll go through throughout the class, okay? There's four ways that you have an option to do it, okay? From your plank pose, shift your way forward. On your exhale, lower down halfway. Inhale, upward dog. Shoulders back strong and straight through your arms. Back knees off of the ground, okay? Exhale, downward dog. Again, strong and long through your upper body, pressing my back thighs towards the back wall, lifting my toes up off of the mat. Okay? That's the first way. Second way is keep holding that plank. If not, drop down to your knee. If not, keep watching. Shift your weight forward. Drop your knees down. Then lower halfway. Two, inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Third way, from the plank. Knees, butt still up. Chest, chin. Shifting your weight forward to a tight cobra. And then pressing back into a downward dog. Last way is to skip it all together. Okay, so from plank back to downward dog. Now, whichever one resonates with you, go there, meet me at a plank position. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, lower down halfway. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Second downward dog, check your fingers. Spread wide, check your feet. Check your arms, check your shoulders. Check your gaze on the first two breaths. The last three breaths, find stillness. Happy feelings. On your next inhale, bend your knees. With one step, or two, or three, try to make it one, close to one as possible. Come to the top of the mat, and meet me in a halfway lift. And then exhale, forward fold again. Engaging your core muscle, protecting your back, reach up high. Exhale, drop your hands. We're gonna go through that one more time with a little bit more rhythm, a little bit faster. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, lower half plank. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Five breaths. Exhale. Exhale. Find stillness with these last three breaths. Last breath here, preparation breath. Come up your toes if you need to on the inhale. Exhale, bend your knees, step, float, or jump to the top of the mat. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, forward fold. We got one more of these. Inhale, reach up through strong cores. Exhale, Birdman hand rub of prosperity and abundance. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, half plank lower. Inhale, upward dog or knee set chin, whatever one you did. Exhale, downward dog. It's okay if you need to use your knees. Be true to your own practice. Inhale onto your tippy toes. Exhale, bend your knees. Inhale, step, float, or walk to the top of the mat for a hit. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach up high. We're gonna go right into Sun B. Exhale, hands to heart center. Birdman hand rub. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, from your hips, sit into a small chair. Okay, now bring your legs to touch, zip them up, slight separation of your heels, okay? Shift your weight back so that you can come up on your toes. Look down, see if you can see your toes, and then reach up high. Take a deep breath in, Exhale, sit a little bit lower in your chair. And instead of arching your back like this, do the opposite and almost bring your ribs together closer to your core, like you're flexing in the mirror, so that you put the pressure on your core rather than your legs. Deep breath in. Exhale, sit a little bit lower. Deep breath in, exhale, forward fold. I was ready to come out of that one. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plank, lower to half plank. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, send your right heel to the sky. Exhale, step through to a low lunge. That might be one or two steps. Just make sure that your ankle is below your knee, okay? Not too much in front. Definitely not behind your knee. You want to make sure that your ankle is here, okay? Creating a strong pillar of support. Strong through your back thigh, lifting your back thigh towards the ceiling. And then your back foot is parallel to the back wall, okay? From here, spin your back heel towards the center line of the mat. Engage your core and lift yourself up into a warrior two. That's opening your hips towards the side wall, spreading your wings, gaze over your front middle finger. Your front knee pointed towards your second pinky toe so that it doesn't come inwards. Actively shift your knee towards the back half of your mat. Be strong through the back leg and the outer edge of your back foot. And look at yourself. Check it out. What does it look like? What does it feel like? Also think about actively squeezing your feet towards each other to create a little bit more stability and balance in your posture. And just hold it for a second, build a little heat. Breathing throughout this time, you don't want to be leaning too far back, hunch too far forward, straight up and down, strong through your legs, engaging that same Uddiyana Bandha, pulling your core in and up. Big inhale here. Exhale, shift your weight forward, reaching your arms forward. Place your front arm on your front thigh. Extend your bicep over your ear and over the top of your head for extended side angle. Legs really didn't do too much moving. They just stayed engaged throughout this point, okay? Strongly long through your top half, spinning your thumb up towards the ceiling, spinning your pinky down towards the ground. Exhale. Keeping your legs the same on your next inhale, windmill your arms back for reverse warrior. Now, sometimes it's easy for me to reach up forward, grab my front body, and keep it square, and then reach. But my legs really didn't do too much movement. And then the exhale, windmill through to chaturanga. Step back into high plank, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, reach left leg high. Left heel high, I should say. Keep your toes pointed down. Inhale, exhale, step through to low lunge. Could be one or two steps. Spin your back heel down. Keeping your toes pointed slightly towards the top of the mat. Engage your core and lift yourself up to fly into warrior two. Check yourself out. Front knee actively moving towards second toe from the pinky.
Whoa.
Press down through your feet towards each other like you're trying to squeeze the mat underneath you. Check your arms, because sometimes that back arm be
a little ADD and doing something different. And just sit here. Strong through your back leg, strong through your front leg. If you can sit a little deeper, inchworm your toes, do so. Feel it. Exhale. Inhale. Shift your weight forward. Drop your front forearm on your front thigh. Reach your hand up and over so that your bicep is over the ear. Spinning your pinky down, thumb up for extended side angle. If you're strong through your core, remove that arm. Grab the back hip or extend it up with the second arm. Keeping my legs the same. Inhale. Reverse it all. Reverse warrior. Exhale. Shift forward, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. 5 breaths here. We're gonna go through that 2 more times. But we're gonna go through it a little bit faster. First time is always a little bit more explanatory. Second times are a lot more flowy. I'm sweating. I don't know if you are yet, but I am. And I want to be free. On the 4th breath here. Inhale, rise up on your tippy toes. Exhale, bend your knees. Inhale, step lower, jump to halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweep forward into a chair. And then exhale, come up high. Birdman hand rub. Going faster. Let's turn the music up. Keep that Birdman hand rub going. Keep them hands warm. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, bring your hands down. Ooh, almost caught me. I almost did that. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, bring your arms down. Now we're going into chair for our inhale. Inhale, sit into your chair. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, lower to half plank or knees to chin. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, right heel high. Exhale, step through, drop your back heel to warrior 2. Inhale, reach forward to extended side angle, drop that front forearm. Exhale, reverse warrior. And then bring it down for chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Left heel high on the inhale. Exhale, step through, drop your back heel. Warrior 2. Ooh. Inhale, shift your weight forward. Extended side angle. Exhale, reverse it. Actually, this should be an inhale. And then exhale. Place your hands down, lower. Shift your weight forward first. And then inhale. Upward dog. Exhale. Downward dog. 5 breaths here. 5 breaths here. It's about to get real interesting. Practice is about to get real interesting. Inhale up on your toes. Exhale, bend your knees. Prepare to jump or step or float to the top of your mat for halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweep up into a chair.
Exhale, Birdman, hand rub. Last one, inhale, reach up high. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Got me, y'all. Y'all see that? Exhale, step back, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Right heel high. Inhale. Step through. Spin your back heel. Warrior two. Inhale, shift forward. Exhale, reverse warrior. This should be an inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, push back. Inhale, send your left leg high, left heel to the sky. Exhale, step through, spin your back heel down for warrior two, wide, expansive. Inhale, reaching forward. Exhale, going backwards. And then spinning through. So exhale, lower. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Five breaths here. Next, we're gonna get into some arm balances. So your arms and your upper body should be pretty warmed up. On your next inhale, come up on your toes. Exhale, bend your knees. Step, float, or jump on an inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sit into a chair. Exhale, Birdman, hand rub. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, sit into a chair. Inhale, hold it. Exhale, sit lower. Toes off the mat. Inhale, hold it. Exhale, sit lower. Hands at prayer. Prayer twist to the right. So bringing your left elbow alongside of your right knee, pressing down through your upper hand into your palm to twist deeper. Hips below your shoulders, long through your spine. Look at your knees, make sure your knees are aligned with each other. Look at your feet, it's okay to correct things. Knees have a tendency, you wanna go in front of the other, make sure that they're aligned with each other. If you can sit deeper in your chair, do it. Exhale, forward fold. Spread your feet about hips distance width apart. Take your two peace fingers, grab your big toes, if possible. Take a deep breath in, lift your chest, engage your back, and then exhale, forward fold. Bend your elbows, pull on your toes to create depth in your stretch. Another very restorative pose. Another very restorative pose. Feel it while you can, get a little rest in. Release your toes, heel toe your feet back to touch. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, strong through your core, reach up high. Exhale, Birdman, hand rub of prosperity and abundance. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. From your halfway lift, bend your knees, drop your hips, and sit into your chair. Reach your hands up last. Prayer twist to the left. So right elbow hooks alongside of the left knee, pressing through the top. It used to help me to bend my fist and push my fist into my hand to expand that twist a little bit. Use your breath to help you twist. Your exhale helps you twist deeper.
your inhale helps you be more long and expansive. Check your knees out, make sure they're not unlevel. And then your next exhale, forward fold. Separate your feet about hips distance width apart. This time we're going on the backs of our hands. So stepping on our palms, toes about to the wrist crease. Okay, so my toes are right at the crease of my wrist here. Okay, and I'm trying to step on my palms. Maybe with my hands all the way down, thumbs down, pinkies down, all fingers down, balance on my hands, lifting my heels off of the mat. And then dropping my head, trusting my balance. Release your wrists, shake your hands out, bend your knees, and you can watch this demonstration of crow pose. In crow pose, I'm already in this position where my knees are slightly bent, and I can either sit into a yogi squat, or I can get my knees far enough on my arms to where they're comfortable. A couple ways you can do it. You can do it knees on the outside, or you can do it knees on the bicep. I prefer knees on the bicep, especially with pants on, because there's grip. And then you bend your elbows backwards. Bend your elbows backwards, wide fingers. Bend your elbows backwards so that you create a shelf, and then place your knees on that shelf. Then from there, shift your weight forward with your toes, not pressing or jumping, just shifting weight forward, reaching my head forward until gravity allows me to maybe take one foot up, then maybe the other foot, okay? That might be enough. Or maybe one foot in both feet, or maybe both feet at a time. Now, if you're advanced, go ahead and jump right into it. Just practice for a minute, see what you get, okay? Other option is from a yogi squat. From a yogi squat, okay? I am sitting up as tall as possible, place my hands down, and whatever my hand width should be, a little bit wider than your shoulders, maybe shoulder length a little bit wider. Squeeze my knees onto my arms, come up onto my toes, squeeze my knees onto my arms, and then shift my way forward until I can just come up off the mat, okay? It's important to make sure you have nothing in front of you. Another cool thing to do is if you have a block, use your block in front of you. And so when you come up, you just place your head on the block, and then you work on coming back off of the block. Okay, so practice that for a second. Practice your crow. If you can do crow, try to straighten your arms out. And then when you're done with crow, meet me in child's pose. This time, knees together, feet separated, sitting back, arms reaching around the back. Third eye reaching forward and then down to the mat. It's okay to move back and forward here like you're skiing or sledding, or if you've ever been on tubes, you know how to go down the hill, get your dynamic. It's important to me. When you're ready, shift forward into a tabletop position. Press yourself back, hips up and back to downward dog. Work on a little bit of balance here. Inhale, lift up on your toes. Exhale, step, bend your knees. Inhale, step, float or jump to the top of your mat for halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, strong through your core, reach up high. Exhale, Birdman, hand rub of prosperity and abundance. Okay, so we did a crow demonstration, and now we're gonna play with crow a little bit more. We've warmed up, and we're gonna try to throw a little side crow in along with a little balance. We also did a lowering of your chair. We're gonna come back to that, but we're gonna add some fun things in to mix it up, and then we're gonna lay down and wrap it up. All right, so come to the top of your mat. Bring your toes to touch.
heels slightly separated, and we're gonna sit into a chair here, okay? So inhale, reach up high, shoulders drop. Exhale, from your hips, sit into your chair. Inhale high. Exhale, bring your hands to heart center. Inhale, prayer twist to the right, left elbow hooks onto the right side. Now, shift your weight over to your right foot and flamingo your left foot for a prayer twist, one-legged balance. When you're ready, slowly extend that left foot back until you're in a prayer twist lunge. Ooh. Exhale, drop your knee. Now really tuck your right elbow close to your elbow, your armpit. Your left elbow is gonna be down here on the side of your hip, placing your palms, sometimes off the mat, placing your palms down and creating that same shelf as you did before. Go into a side crow. Either knees together, one leg extended, whichever one, play with it. See if you can get it again. From that lunge, from that twist, maybe my elbows up high, I get my elbow really down on that. So almost to where my thigh is in my armpit. This back knee is super low on my hip, shifting my weight forward, really placing this hip on this arm first to gain balance. And then just shifting forward too. I find balance through my wrists and my fingertips. And then when you're ready, meet me back in the low lunge. Bring your arms into the center, in between your right foot. So bring both arms in between your right foot for a runner's lunge. Drop your forearms down. Sometimes it helps to roll to the outer edge of your right foot, really pressing your knee to that side wall. And breathing is the most important thing here. Breathe into all of these deep stretches. Place your hands back down. Take your left hand, place it firmly below your left shoulder. Roll again to the outer edge of your right foot. Press your right knee out to the side. Open your body to the right. Bend your back knee and see if you can grab that back foot. You might not be able to grab it, but just bending and activating that muscle should send some attention to your front quad. If you can, grab it on the inside and turn and look back. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, bring it in a little closer. Switch your hand to the outside. And then shift your gaze, turn your chest, open up to the front. And then on your next exhale, release. Place your hand back on the outside of your right foot. Strong and long through your back leg. Inhale, step up. Halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach up high, strong through your core. Exhale, Birdman hand rub. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, sit into your chair. Sit from your hips, feet to touch. Wrists or heels slightly separated. Toes off of the mat. Knees even. Inhale, hands to prayer. Exhale, prayer twist to the left. So right elbow hooks alongside of the right knee. Dropping your hips lower than your shoulders. Checking your knees, making sure they're even. Shift your weight over to the left foot. Strong and long through the left foot. Steady your gaze and flamingo that foot for as long as possible. Extend it back. Whoa! For a side twist. twisted crescent. Drop your back knee. Drop that. Let me do it over here so you can see. Drop that knee in that armpit. This back elbow really goes a lot lower on this bottom hip. And then you come forward, shift your weight forward until you find it. Play with it. And when you're ready, meet me back in the lunge. And we're gonna bring our hands to the inside of our left foot. Almost roll our foot out to the outer edge of it. The left foot out to the outer edge. Sending my left knee out to the left. And then dropping down as low as possible. That might be here. That might be all the way down here. It might be even lower. Be true to your practice. Keeping my right hand rooted into the ground, strong and long through my left arm. Turning, opening my body to the left. Bending that back leg and see if I can reach it. Can I reach it? Can I grab it? If not, cool. If I can, grab it on the inside. The inside. And turn and look towards the side or the back wall. Long through your front big toe. And then shift it and to the opposite side. Turn your gaze to the front room and square your shoulders. And then release, arm back to the outside. Press through your back heel to lift your back knee. Exhale. Inhale, step up, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, sit into a chair again. Inhale in your chair, lift your toes. Exhale, sit lower. Inhale. Exhale, sit lower. Inhale. Exhale, sit all the way down to the ground and land in a boat pose. That might be a boat with your arms up. That might be a boat with your arms back. We just want to have our legs zipped up and our shins parallel with the ground, chest up high, engaging our core instead of sinking in our back. And we're going to breathe here. So take a deep breath in. And then exhale. On your next inhale, we're going to go to half boat. Inhale. Lower halfway. Exhale, come up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, come up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, come up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, come up. Faster. Inhale, lower. Exhale, come up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, come up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, come up. Oh, and then balance. Grab your big toes in between your legs. So balancing still on your sit bones. And grab your big toes. If you can, extend your legs straight out. Kapalabhati here, okay? So take a deep breath in. Exhale completely. Inhale. Exhale. And then start. Slow, sharp inhales through your nose. Chest up high. Exhale fully. Hold it. Hold your exhale for as long as possible. Inhale. Exhale. Release your feet. Extend them straight in front of you. Sit up tall. Take a deep breath in. Reach your arms up high. Exhale, keeping your chest up for as long as possible. Fold forward. Keeping your chest up for as long as possible. Fold forward. Keeping your chest up for as long as possible. Chest and head. Last thing to drop. Pull your toes back towards your skull to activate your calves. And breathe here. Take a deep breath in. Look up. Lift your chest. Exhale, fold a little deeper. Sip your legs up a little closer. See if you can touch your heels. See if you can touch your fingers. See if maybe you can grab your wrist or your hand. Keep going. Keep folding. You're golden. And release your hands. Exhale, come up. Cobbler's pose, so feet to touch, knees wide on the mat, okay? So I'm putting my heels as close to my center as possible. And I'm also almost trying to open my feet like a book. So keeping my bottom half, outer edge of my feet touching, opening my feet like a book. And just like in the beginning of the class, sitting tall as possible and breathing. Long in the collarbone. Shoulders wide, chest wide. And then exhale, release your legs, shake them out. Bring them back in to touch. Same thing one more time. See if you can get a little deeper. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, fold a little bit forward with it. Bring your elbows in and open your foot like it's a book. Again, let your head and your shoulders be the last thing to fall. So when you fold like this, keep your chest up for as long as possible, just to stay long and expansive through your whole spine. And then let your head come last. On your next inhale, lay all the way back on your mat. Keeping your legs spread like that. Spread your arms wide like a T. So arms wide like a T. Bring your toes, your knees in. Hug your knees, hug yourself. Give yourself a hug. This might be the first hug you got all day. This might be the last hug you get today. So make sure that it is a good hug, a beneficial hug. Hug yourself. Love yourself. Oh. And then drop your heels as close to your butt as possible. Now you can go wheel, full wheel pose, or you can just go bridge pose, whichever one you want, but I want to throw a back bend in here before we leave out. Bridge pose, rolling your shoulders underneath your back. Interlacing your fingers underneath yourself, so making a fist here, pressing actively down into the floor with that fist and those straight arms. And then lifting your hips up off of the mat, squeezing your knees together, creating tension, creating heat and action all along your back and your spine, spinal muscles. If you're going full wheel, hands pointed back towards the body above your head. And then again, pressing up through your hips. If you load it here, press back to on your toes. And then press up. And then when you're ready, slowly lower yourself down. Bring your knees back to your chest. Roll it around a little bit. Grab each big toe, with your toes for a happy baby. Sending my knees towards the floor, actively still pressing into my hands. Actively pulling my core towards my spine. And just really like almost feeling my whole back with the ground here. How low can I go on my spine? Where? What does it feel like if I put flatten each part of my back in this happy baby? Stretch your leg out if you need to, which is a great place to just get those last little irking jerks out. And then when you're ready, shake them out. Take your right leg over your left knee. Take your arms out to the side again. And then drop your knees, both knees, to the right. Using your right foot to press your left knee closer to the ground. Gazing to the left for a gentle twist, an aggressive gentle twist, an active gentle twist. And then when you're ready, coming back to center, switching the two, other side. Dropping to the right, using your right foot to actively press your left knee, or your left foot to actively press your right knee into the ground, into the mat. And then when you're ready, come back to the top, drop your legs down. Spread your arms wide for the corpse pose, the final frontier, the last thing. Stretch out, be long, be wide, be aggressive with your corpse pose right now. This is the opportunity to do so. Lay it on out. Breathe, tune in, tap in. Tapped into your breath. Tune in to yourself. Follow your thoughts. Where does your mind go when you sit in silence? Let's see, what are you thinking about right now? Let's follow it. Let's go. I invite you to stay in your savasana for
for as long as you need.